Welcome, Sunday morning, 6 a.m. here Pacific Standard Time, as we bring to you a Sunday morning kickoff. We're here with Anita and the man over Ustream, YouTube, Facebook, and Twitter. And again, the excellency of God's love pours through us as we say, Anita and I love you. And again, I'm the man, Bryant Hewitt. And we're going to be speaking, continuing with our series of with Proverbs 5, but we'll start that up again on Monday. And with the importance of the other topic of prayer and with wisdom and the gaining wisdom, we need faith. So we're going to cover that today. And just as we're getting ready for morning prayer, let's go to Romans 10, chapters verses 17 through 21 will be our foundation scriptures for the day. Let's pray. Dear Jesus, we thank you for this time, your endless rhyme of love, the branch to the vine that you gave us your birth, the second birth when we became redeemed, for we are redeemed because of you. As you lead us to the kingdom-bound road, many are chosen, but many are called, but few are chosen. And we thank you for your love. We thank you for your support. We thank you for the clarity of the mind and the new heart. For in Jesus' name, we love thee. Again, so let me just take a little sip of this coffee here at 6 a.m., getting ready for a busy Sunday, and my wife sends her love to everybody. And let's go forth in Jesus' name with our foundation scriptures. Again, Romans chapter 10, verse 17. So then faith cometh by hearing, hearing by the word of God. But I say, have they not heard? Yes, verily, their sound went into all the earth, and their words unto the ends of the world. But I say, did not Israel know? First Moses saith, I will provoke you to jealousy by them that are no people, and by a foolish nation I will anger you. But Esau is very bold, and saith, I was found of them that sought me not. I was made manifest unto them that asked not after me. But to Israel he saith, all day long I have stretched forth my hands unto a disobedient and gainsaying people. So we have unto ourselves the truth, the reality, the opportunity to move into faith. What were we waiting for? The book of Romans tells us about the grace of God. Let's start with that. Grace can be presented as God's riches at Christ's expense. Christ came down to you with an open arms as he stretched those arms open upon the cross for you. At the point of his resurrection, he defeated the curse of the law, poverty, sickness, and death, and embraced you and said, I love you. It's time to get very personal with your own life, with God. It's time to get very personal with your family members. And it's time to slow dance with Jesus. We speak of the truth and the realities of God brings us. Grace can be articulated again at God's riches at Christ's expense. Jesus died on the cross in agony and blood for our sins in order to provide us all the riches of God. And faith means forsaking all, I trust all. So we're saying, well, Brian, you're giving me this opportunity to do this and do that with your ministry. Can you put something on the table? Well, God, we can't negotiate with God. We seem to feel that if we can't do it with God, we can do it with man. But God placed his only guarantee on the table, his son, to open the door of faith for you, to move into the house of salvation, to have that knowledge that you defeated the curse of the law, poverty, sickness, and death. Faith receives what grace provides. Faith receives what grace provides. Without faith, there is no way to acquire the grace of God. Let's write down some scriptures, and then at your own blessed time, please get into them. Ephesians chapter 2, verse 8 and 9. I ask you to pray through these scriptures. Again, faith receives what grace provides. Are you with me so far? We have to be true to the true to that with our former teardrops we had the night before. God brings us a joy in the morning. What difficulties we had with one stumbling block after another, we now have the strength and the supernatural vision that God has bestowed upon us, and the Spirit of God living inside of us to walk through these stumbling blocks as Christ has given us strength to do. There is no wavering, there is no excuses not to pray. Our brains have been cleared, or we have been given a new heart. God has given us the blessings of a circumcision of the new heart, removing the stony edges and placing that new heart inside of you. And you're courageous in strength because prayer gives us that time, hope, faith. Faith gives us love. And again, faith gives us the strength to understand all three. Faith gives us the power and the spirits, the nine fruits of the spirits found in Galatians chapter 5, verse 22. Again, in Galatians chapter 5, verse 22. And love is the number one gift. How can we spend so much time hating each other and trying to compete with each other just for claiming to have a stronger lifestyle? Now, God wants you to be a beacon of light and a beacon of an example. So what I'm saying with these messages, as well as my wife, is that yes, God wants a sacrifice. He wants change from you. He wants you to get into the practice of fasting, the art of fasting. That doesn't mean you have to give up your craft, doesn't mean you have to give up anything, but you can be an example in that, within that industry, in the power of change of Jesus Christ. Grace is God's ability. Faith is man's ability, responsibility. It is our responsibility to respond to God's grace. It is our responsibility to respond to God's grace. Now let's grab this pen and paper. And let's really do some rocking and tap dancing through the Bible today. Do you want to be saved? Romans chapter 5, verse 1. Do you want to be saved? Simple yes or no. As you have heard me say many times, you can't, if you're going to hell, go to hell first class. Go to heaven first class. Don't waste your time being lukewarm because God's going to spit you out. Let me just touch base on Romans chapter 5, verse 1. Therefore, being justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ. So we have peace through our Lord. Peace through our Lord Jesus Christ. Peace of mind. How many of you wake up during the week and you don't have that? Okay, how many of you need to have that manner of faith, that manner of love just take over you, engulf you? Behold, what manner of love the Father hath bestowed upon us that we should be called the sons of God. That's from 1 John chapter 3, verse 3. The sons of God. Do you want to be sanctified? Please pray through the scripture, Acts chapter 15, verse 9. Do you want your prayers answered? And you hear me say that often. That's from Mark 11, verse 24. And you can express the personal prayer time between you and God, your quiet time, from Mark chapter 11, verse 23 through 26. Do you want to overcome the world? I've done it. Why can't you? Doesn't mean you're making $20 million a motion picture anymore or rocking and rolling with concerts. We need to move forward. So do you want to overcome the world? Pray through that scripture in 1 John chapter 5, verse 4. Faith is the medium of exchange in the kingdom of heaven. Faith is the medium of exchange in the kingdom of heaven. We bring this understanding in God's glory. We bring this to us tonight. Unbelief is slander against God. God said to be strong in faith, so if we are weak in faith, we are disobedient to God. We must get into the practice of studying Father Abraham, his life. He rested on the promises of God. Promises of God were received to him 25 years after the initial promise. What more do we want? In Matthew chapter 13, verse 58, the Bible says that Jesus limited his ability to do mighty works because of the people's unbelief. So, we limit God's talents and gifts when we show our unbelief, because we're not enabling God to do his gifts because we're showing unbelief. Oh, I can do this without you, God. No. No. We live in a very confusing world. God needs you. God wants you. God wants you to be a change maker of this world. God wants you to challenge the leaderships of this world so you can be strong in faith. The object of faith, Almighty God, know him. Know God. Faith is not a positive thinking or hoping for the best. Faith is not better than its object. Misplaced faith is a terrible thing. The object of our faith is God himself. The object of our faith is God himself. We can do this, brethren. We can do this and move this together. We can change the mountains. We can express change. We can talk change. And Mark 11:22. Kicking off that prayer that I often say to you, Mark 11:23, verse 26. And Jesus answered saith unto them, saying, have faith in God. Romans 10:11, please pray through that. Weak faith in the right object is better than misplaced faith in any object. Weak faith in God is better than strong faith in anything else. We can't misplace faith like we're misplacing our cell phones. We can't bring such of our reality and try to present that to God's reality. We can't go to the ways of man of sinful nature, especially those who call themselves God, borrow $20 million from them, buy a huge stadium, then expect Jesus to pay it back. It's not going to happen. It is not going to happen. In biblical accounts, most who received a blessing from God had weak faith. But God blesses us and gives us that courageous strength, but we also have to get into the practice of prayer, the repentance, the art of fasting, the movements of the scriptures, knowing that faithful and true, Jesus Christ is coming back with a vengeance. So do we want to be caught up in the rapture and join that army? After we have a wonderful dinner called the Marriage Supper of the Lamb, we take back the planet for dessert. It is time to understand the origin of faith, the Word of God. Hear him. We must learn to listen to God if we should have faith. So, in this halfway point of our broadcast, brothers and sisters, Romans 10:13, for whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. It's time to kick forward, move forward in the name of Jesus. It's time to express God's love, God's understanding. Do we want this? Yes or no? Are we going to express our truth? So let's come forward. Let's be redeemed together, one mind and one judgment of Christ, and let's do the sinner's prayer together. Dear God, I admit I am a sinner and need your forgiveness. I believe that Jesus Christ died in my place, paying the penalty for my sins. I am willing right now to turn from my sin and accept Jesus Christ as my personal Lord and Savior. I commit myself to you and ask you to send the Holy Spirit into my life and to fill me and take control and to help me become the kind of person you want me to be. Thank you, Father, for changing me. Thank you, Lord, for making me. That is my wife singing in the background here at 6:15 in the morning here in Los Angeles. Angels are singing in your name. Hallelujah! The change is upon us in Jesus' name. We are expressing God's reality, the faith that is living inside of you. We continue all with these messages, the full length of a 28-minute series, every day, five times a week, Monday through Friday, Saturday and Sunday, busy schedule, so we kick in at the times you can see in our schedule. But we invite you to be a partner with us. Visit us at bryanthewitt.com and join us, and do bless us with a financial gift, and God will bestow you with riches that you've yet to receive, in Jesus' name. And as we go forward with our offering of obedience, God invites you once again into all relationships, in all manner of his presence, and we move again into you and I getting to know each other. And Anita and the man invite you to our crusades. We want you to travel with us. We want you to plant a financial blessing into our ministry. That ministry, even though you could be a millionaire, even though you could only have $1 to your name, you could just be hustling money in a card game or poker game, but we want you to walk away with that and have faith in God. And put that dollar on the altar of God and say, Lord, take me, love me, I'm yours, and God's going to bless that dollar 100-fold, 7,000-fold. You'll have blessings pouring down from the windows of heaven. That's your own apartment, your homes, your storehouses of your barns, ranches will not be able to hold them. Now, if you're saying, well, how can I receive these blessings if I'm homeless? God is asking, blessing you, giving you a vision to live above your circumstances. God is already showing you that apartment. You are moving in God's steps, God's grace, God's manner. And before we ask for wisdom and discernment every day, let's say this, dear Jesus, I want to know you ever so more every day. Oh yes, Solomon did ask for wisdom and discernment. But what he never asked for was, God, I want to know you ever so more every day. And at the end, later part of his life, he lived his life in disgrace. This, God created you for the whole picture. The young, the middle-aged, the old. Not so much, yes, we had our own little bits of fun, sinful nature, and some of our mistakes we did enjoy. We had fun with. That's the truth. But we go beyond that because we are being dragged. People are trying to put that yoke of bondage around us that we all know and move forward in the matchless name of Jesus. We do this by being change makers of the world. The origin of faith, the word of God, hear him. We're not listening to God. Hearing is receiving, but is hearing done? So my wife and I come to your computers, your living rooms, your homes, your offices, your buses, cafes, yes, excellent place to fellowship in the name of Jesus besides church. But we encourage you to hear God, because we will be repeating the same scriptures over and over again till everybody, when I say everybody, I mean everybody, is in unison with the Holy Spirit. Now, we live in a confusing world, but God is not the author of confusion, nor are you and I. So God needs you to be the editor, to bring faith, to bring the strong love of Jesus, and to take away confusion from the headlines of the new media news and the old media news, and bring forward the truth and faith and God's love. I ask you to pray through Romans 10:8, Romans 10:14. We must learn to listen to God if we would have faith. We cannot pray outside the will of God and have our prayers answered, and in order to pray in the will of God, we have to hear the word of God. So in order to pray in the will of God, we have to hear the word of God. We cannot generate faith. Faith comes. So we must, with that faith that is coming, God is asking us to die daily and to crucify ourselves daily with Christ. And that is the measurement of our faith will be poured upon us. Romans 10:17 and 2 Peter 1:1. Faith is not a leap in the dark. It is a step in the light. It is a step in the light. The instrument of God uses to enable us to believe is his word, the word of God. It is not simply the Bible that we hold in our hands that give us faith. It is God speaking to us through the Bible. Hebrews 11:1. Faith is a substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. Faith is not a feeling. Faith is not something you can see or touch or taste. Anything that resembles the senses of the ways of man is not a part of it. But God gives you that faith. God wants you to move forward into his arms and to yield to him. For the object of faith, the will of God, yield to him. Cry to him. Faith is not man's way of getting man's will in heaven. Faith is God's way of getting God's will done on earth. It is God's will for everyone to be saved, and he has sent messengers to carry the gospel message. And that's you. That's me. That's Anita. We bring to you the instrument of truth. God wants all of you, all of us, to use that instrument of truth. Let us repent of our lives, our adultery, our addictions, our habits, our complacency. Complacency, I put equal. Yours truly puts equal to murder and adultery. If I have knowledge of your addiction and do nothing about it, I'm guilty of that sin. I'm using you for my own gain so you can still have addictions and take over your lifestyle. I see that every day in the area that I live in. We have to take that word and move away from those who refuse the word of God. We are not saved through faith and works. We are saved through faith that works. We are saved through faith that works. So if I'm saying, well, someone told me that faith without works is dead, so that's all I need to do to be saved, we need to understand that our faith, we are saved through faith that works. We present ourselves, we ask God to give us, to come and command our thoughts so we can present our works to Him. Faith that works through God. And with the reality that God gives us, we now are change makers of the world. We are not saved because of our works. We work because we are saved. James chapter 2, verse 20, pray through that scripture. Faith is a gift of God. God gives us the opportunity to either refuse or accept His gift. So, brethren, receive God today. It's a simple truth. Words cannot express the gratitude within my heart, within my wife's heart, when I say, Heavenly Father, what God brought us from, my wife told she would never walk again, but she said, the doctor, I refuse that. Get thee behind me, Satan. When she was bleeding to death, God healed her. God saved her. When I was having my fun with the task that was assigned to me and several health problems before that, God healed me. God brings you from when I spent time on the streets away from my family in the addictions of gambling. God brought me out of that, but also gave me new talents. And with the utmost humility, I move forward in Christ. Yes, in my walk with Christ for the past 20 years, I did make my mistakes. Some of them I enjoyed, but I'm not totally proud of it. But I have moved forward in the arms of Christ. God has forgiven me because I lift up new repentance every day. God pours down new mercies upon not just me, but all of us every day. Dear Jesus, we thank you for your love. We thank you for your kindness. We lift up all repentance today. Rise, tears, fears. Moving away from anything in the spirit of darkness that creates. But you, Lord, we just move into your nine fruits of the Spirit that you have created for us in the abundance of faith that works for us to move order. So we ask you to forgive us of all of our sins, of all of our trespasses, of all of our debts, as we forgive our debtors. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Ask, seek, and knock, brethren. Ask, seek, and knock. It's time to really be change makers of the world and come forward. Again, let's go over what we just expressed here this morning. Again, the object of faith, the work of God, obey Him. The object of faith, the will of God, yield to Him. The origin of faith, the word of God, hear Him. The object of faith, Almighty God, know Him. Misplaced faith is a terrible thing. It is not like losing a cell phone and that your wife or friends can find it an hour later. And it is about the grace of God that leads us to the strength of faith. Forsaking all, I trust all. That is faith. Grace is God's ability. Faith is man's responsibility. And it is our responsibility to respond to God's grace. We must lift up prayer. Prayer is our greatest privilege, but it's also our greatest failure. go forward in the arms of Christ, knowing and believing that the power of Jesus Christ comes to all of us, comes to all of us in the matchless name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, take the torch, feel that fire. We ask you to come and get to be involved with your new life, your new strength of God. Show your strength with those in relationships, churches, midweek Bible studies, Sunday services, fellowship. The strength of the Lord Jesus Christ lays before you. Lay your life on the altar of God, Lord. Take me, love me, I'm yours. Dear Lord, remove me from this path of sin. In Jesus' name. Anita and the men invite you. We want to get to know you. We want to know you. Do visit us at BryantHewitt.com. Click on the donation link to come and travel with us. We ask you for your prayers and support as you go to Kenya, Nigeria, Cape Town, South Africa, Tanzania, Madagascar, just checked in. Going to England a couple times in 2012, Australia 2013, Northern and Southern India. And brethren, our work continues here in the United States, here in Los Angeles. We're going to the Upper Great Lake regions in a few months as well. As well, brethren, we are moving. As well as our blessed work continues in Canada. We go forward in the matchless name of Jesus. We ask you again, if you become that financial partner with us, you are going to be blessed with the abundance through your obedience, through your blessings, 100-fold, 700-fold, from just goes beyond just a new car, new house. It'll be a financial blessing that the storehouse, the windows of heaven will open up and pour unto you. In the matchless name of Jesus, in Jesus' name, amen. So we have discussed faith. What is it? What can it do for me? What can it do for you? We are moving forward into the arms of Christ. The attitude of gratitude. The attitude of gratitude brings us to the realities of God's love, God's truth. Move into faith. Move into His love. Again, grace is God's ability. Faith is man's responsibility. That it's our responsibility to move into the grace of God. Let's pray. Dear Jesus, we thank you for this time, your endless rhyme, giving us the message in the presence of you, O God, the practice, the moving into the grace, and asking us to receive the faith that you bestow upon us. We die daily, we are crucified daily as we walk into the truth of your reality of your love, Lord. We thank you for covering us with the blood of Calvary. We thank you from the manger to the cross. We thank you we have gone from a testimony to a victory testimony. We have the victory in Jesus' name. We thank you for this new day. We're pouring down the joys of the morning, the new mercies of this day. And if our day is ending, we take this time, your endless rhyme, and share the love of the Lord. In Jesus' name, we love thee. Anita and the men love you on this blessed Sunday morning. We walk by faith and not by sight. We thank you for your time, and until next time, au revoir, adios, good day for the people.